What's going on, guys? Hit pause here for the next part of this series, and in this part we're actually going to do something completely different for me, probably not for you guys viewing, but I'm gonna actually create the map. So what I'm gonna do is, the idea is that it's a picnic map. Now I have a reference. Okay, so here is what I had originally created in UDK. Now, as you can see, it's fairly simple. There's not a lot going on. We have a picnic blanket. We have some food, right, the cheese. We got some sandwiches, some sodas, some OJ, a couple cups here and there. I'm in a picnic basket, a little bit of fruit, like a banana hanging out. I don't know why I do that, because I would never let that fly, right? So let me put something on there, and it's going to squish it, and then there's a perfectly good banana just gone. But I got more reference here, so you can see there's fruit in there. Here's the sandwiches, here's the cheese, we've got a pie, here's a bit of a low shot, and then here is the shot that I'm going to look at the most, probably. Let's see, is there any more? This one and this one. Now, if you look here, the way I did the blanket was, I don't know if it's exactly efficient, but it's fairly genius in my opinion. I thought it was a kind of a creative use of landscape. That's how I did it. Okay. Well, in UDK it was terrain or landscape, whatever you called it there. But you know, you can actually like tune it around some meshes and things. So that'll be what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna bring in the lowest res landscape that I can possibly create. I am going to place down my assets where I need them, and then I'm gonna sculpt wrinkles and things around it as if they're just very small hills. Okay, so you'll be mostly on flat surface, but at the same time it is gonna be kinda lumpy here and there. So I literally right click to try to turn the camera there, which was stupid. Alright, so let's do some stuff here. Let's get rid of this. I don't want to get rid of the ground yet. What is this? This is the nav volume. This is light mass. That goes. This will be dynamically lit. These things can pretty much go. I'm going to keep all the ones that are on the ground because they actually might help me align something. And we'll leave everything else at that. So let's go straight to the landscape tool. And what is the smallest that we can do? 7x7 quads is a fairly good area. I'm going to go ahead and say that this isn't too shabby. It's fairly large. I mean, if you think of this as the blanket, you know, the ants creatures. Wait, no, this is a folder that would never go away even if I delete it. It just keeps coming back. I don't know what's that all about. Creatures, ant, and we'll get the mesh here and we'll just throw them in there. So you figure, I think that's pretty good. I mean, it's as small as I can get. What does that do? Does that make it bigger? Yeah, I don't want that. I want small. I mean, I could maybe try 9x9, and the reason for that is because what usually happens, this is just kind of a side note, but what usually happens when I'm bringing in terrains and stuff from like World Machine is that the number of components wouldn't be like 16, it would be 17, and I would get this stretched component at the end, right? We've all seen it. Well, I actually want that because I want my texture to be nice cubes, but then I want it to stretch out on the end like it's the edge of the blanket, you know? That's what I want. Damn it. So I'm gonna do it. Alright. I think that's about all I really need to do. So let's just create. Alright. And I think I just want to move it up a hair. Well, or maybe I want to move it down a hair. Because that's world zero. In the Z? Isn't that a better floor than where the hell this is at? I think so. Control-Alt to make that box, by the way. Let me get rid of that. that, and then we'll try to hit end. Yeah, drops it all down to the floor. All right, and actually, so move everything up just a little bit. I did my lights and everything, so that's okay. All right, so here is my terrain. I should probably get the I think I actually have the picnic basket. Here's a nice handy thing. I want to get this right in there, perfect, where it's supposed to line up. So watch this. Select this. Ta-da! How did I do that? All right, I'll show you. Control C, Control V. I now have a duplicate in the exact same spot. I have this selected in the content browser, so I just right click and say replace. That is the quickest and easiest way to do that kind of thing. So I actually have this material. This may or may not work. I doubt the tiling is going to be what I want. Or I could be perfectly mistaken. Now what happened at the edge? Nah, I didn't stretch it. Sacrificizer. There's a way to... I don't even know what that's used for. Manage selection. Okay. And I would like to hit the delete key. Go to the delete. Oh, I just click on it. Sweet. Okay. And now I should be able to come in here with a very small brush. I'll probably actually swap over to, let's see, strength is fairly low. This is really low res. The other idea that I had would be that I would actually do this in like Mudbox or something, where I sculpt it elsewhere and then do the height map. Now here's the thing, there's not going to be no world machine involved in this one, right? I don't want erosion, you know? That would be weird. That would be super weird, so I'm not going to do that. This might be too low res. Can't I hold shift and smooth it? Yeah. This is very low res. I don't know if I'm going to get... This, however, was high res. I remember that. This one was too high res. I can tessellate, but to smooth it out. Which would be kind of a smart approach in a sense. Because that would be two layers of detail control. But maybe if I can get away with not doing it. This does feel very low resolution, though. I mean, you can see it pretty clearly that I don't have a lot of, you know, I don't have a lot of detail to work with here. I've only got sorry, but I've only got like two segments here. You know, I literally one line I can raise here. There's no way I'm gonna be able to make wrinkles. This is too fucking low. Shit. Well, hang on. Maybe I can just go one up from that or something. There's no way to change it here, by the way. Once you're done, you're done. But I can delete it. See, here's what you can do. You can actually pretty much perfectly finely, without, I don't think, any problems, is you can shrink these things. You know what I'm saying? So I could shrink it and add a bunch more components, or I could just make a new one. I think in this case, it's going to be better for me to just make a new one. So let's go boom. And yeah, that now that I can see the scale of the things that I have to kind of adjust around, you can see where the this is even so low res, you can see every vert that's here. So all that's actually going to happen, let's try, maybe I should double it, which makes it bigger, twice as big. But what happens is then I scale it down twice as small. So overall resolution, maybe I should go like 256 by 250. Well, it won't let me do that, will it? Okay, well, it's just letting me do that. So now that's really big, but if I scale that down, I should get, this is taking up about two. Yeah, I should get about four times the resolution that I had before. So 4 points for every one that I had. I think that that's fair. I'm not asking for too much. God damn it. So then I should just be able to select that and throw you on, which from out here looks pink, right? I mean, it just looks like a pink flat color. Isn't that crazy? But it's in fact red and white. Even from here it goes pink. Eyes, our crazy eyes. Okay, so let's scale this down to 0.25 of what it... Oh, no, 25. This is 100 scale for some strange reason. And I still feel like that's a good size. It's about what I was working with before. A little bit wider than my original test area, but that's okay. Let's get this guy back on zero. Very reflective, this surface. It's got, I don't think it has anything actually on it. But let's test. How do you feel now, buddy? That does feel better. Now let's see if I was about correct with the four times thing. Yeah, I mean, there's pretty much the three or four right where I originally had one, so I think I'm cool with it. I think I can go. I can go. I don't know how long this is going to take. If I remember correctly from before when I did this in UDK, that it took forever. But I also kind of remember that I didn't really focus on it like all the way. Okay, hang on. That was not right. What? Do I have to actually switch to a smooth brush? Is there no smooth brush? Like no smooth modifier for this? Because I think shift goes down. Control does nothing. Alt just moves camera. So yeah, there's no modifier for smoothing, which we should have that, I think. You also can't sculpt too fast here. If you do, you end up with this kind of effect, where you just get a few lumps here and there. Just a few scattered spots that can't keep up. Just go slow. Just patience. That's all you can do on this. Alright. Let's go. Let's add some larger stuff. Some edges. Nope, I don't want to really adjust the strength. I want to do the size. Fall off. I want to be fairly high. Oof, this is gonna be rough. I could have swore I boosted the size. I don't know how it went back down, but it did. Holy sh! There we go. That's a little bit better speed. I'm gonna also go uncross-eyed here because this material isn't even finished yet. Doesn't have the normals and stuff. I'm just gonna go ahead and clear that. I think it's gonna be better just to look at it like this. So I'm just going to mark a few lines and then I'll try to clean them up later as best I can. It's really hard to see. What I think actually can make this kind of thing easy to see is if I take a real extreme approach on the geometry and then okay, I want to hide everything with the lights. Yeah, that should make it. So here's my marker for the. It's gonna be kind of hard to do this, but we'll see. You can use your pen tablet if you have one. So I just want to kind of draw a general flow here. Seems weird, like almost like if I go this direction it's okay, but if I go this direction it just doesn't feel right. And it's so weird. Keeping in mind that for the most part you're going to be down in it, but I don't want to use that as like any kind of like excuse for why something may or may not look shitty, because if I do have like a bunch of shit spots where I don't focus on it, then I do limit myself on what I can show in my camera, you know? It's so hard to sculpt when it keeps bulging the one spot and then just, you know, losing its shit before it gets to the next one, you know? That's why I was half tempted to do this in, like, you know, like I said, like Mudbox or something. Because I would be able to do this pretty lightning quick and I could get the same damn thing, right? And I just bring it in as a height map. I just got to make sure that I save it out as the correct size and format, which raw. That's one thing World Machine is better at. I'm going to get my pen tablet out and see if this is any more comfortable, because I'm going to be honest with you guys, I'm already cramping. I cannot stand drawing or painting or sculpting or doing anything with the mouse like that anymore. Holding the button down while trying to like keep a correct stroke, ugh, sucks. It's just my opinion though. Here we go. So this is pen tablet. It still feels totally weird when I go this direction. I don't know why that is. And it's not my, like the way my hand feels. It feels like it's just like it can't catch up that way. I have to go slower. Okay, I can actually move around. I'm navigating up, down, left, right with my pen tablet, which is pretty cool. I have to hold one of the buttons on the pen, and then I can WASD around, so I don't lose much mobility here. Not really much at all. I don't, however, have, I don't really know what this does. Yeah, I don't like that. It's, let's try a linear fall off. We might get better wrinkles this way. Some of these just have to get so goddamn huge before, you know, like this bump right here, it's really rather unwieldy. Now, I can't do any kind of like fold, you know, I just can't, because I can only move verts in the Z, right? So, let's pull this down just a little bit. As odd as it sounds, I may actually be able to get away with hydro erosion to give myself more of a peak, but I probably gotta fiddle with the settings a lot more. It's limiting itself right there. I gotta try to basically figure out a single detail and see if I can't reproduce it everywhere. I guess my main concern is it being as smooth as I can get it. Thing is, I don't believe I have pen pressure control, but I may. Actually, let me test that. Do I? Okay, I'm gonna barely press. Now I'm gonna press real hard. I felt pretty much exactly the same. So I don't have that kind of control yet. That sucks. It's supposed to actually have it, I thought. Maybe I don't think I have it set up right. I gotta not have it set up right. Alright, let me do this. I think my directional flow is kind of screwed up. So I think the fair thing to do here is to not focus on this in a video, right? I don't think anybody wants to see me go through this nightmare. Given that though, what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to give it like a 10 or 15 minute treatment, okay? Off camera, and then I'll come back. I'm just going to try to accentuate a few things here and there. Again, the main point for me right now is not exactly it, every wrinkle being exactly where I want it and driving any kind of flow or anything like that. It's a little bit of a test at this stage of the tools. I'm probably, honest with everybody, I really kind of feel like I want to not do this in this program. You know what I'm saying? Like, I want to do it in like Mudbox or someplace where I've got like the tools that I'm used to. I can work on the correct amount of resolution, no problem. So what I could do is maybe just mark something like this spot right here, and then take it from there, right? And I can make sure that I only sculpt in the Z and whatnot like that on a perfect cube. So I think that's what I'm going to do. So what I'll do right now is, like I said, just going to accentuate a few things off camera. I'll come back here in split second. It should basically, about, I don't think I'll have the same camera view, but it should look a little better, but it's not going to look good. Don't anybody expect this to look good. Okay, so here's what I ended up with. Don't like it. Not at all. I'm going to do something different, but for now, it's okay. It doesn't really matter what it is. I just need lumps. Now, the thing is I went ahead and kept some steepness to this whole thing. And the reason is because I thought that maybe it would be a good test to see how the AI is going to perform in this kind of environment, you know. It might actually even be too steep for the nav mesh, so I might need to fix the nav mesh. So let me take a look at what's happening here. As you can see, my nav mesh bounds volume is all out of thwack here, so let's go ahead and get a nice centered feel to this whole thing. So we'll say 6500, and I'm almost tempted to move this to world 0 so that like my 0 point can be right where the basket is, you know, like that's world 0 right there, you know. I don't know how handy that's gonna be, but we'll see. And I just gotta move it down. Alright, so you can see we lose. Now this right here is not lost nav mesh. There is nav mesh here. I don't know if I get to see it. Might be coplanar. It's there. The only time that there's no nav mesh is when you get that actual border. Okay. All this stuff is just the nav mesh kind of poking through. It's there though. So as you can see from up here, well, I can't really see those edges from here. Let's see. Maybe unlit would help. Yeah. Well, I guess from here. So you can see where it's broken and it can't figure out the slope. So I may want to fix that, or I may want to keep it for now, because they do have a path over it. They can go across the top of it. So you like right here, you see that the nav mesh is like way up here, and you're thinking, oh god, you know, that's horrible. How are they going to follow that? The fact is that, you know, the nav mesh is just kind of like a, hey, in this general area, and then your character still goes down here. You know what I'm saying? Even though the nav mesh is way up there. So he's looking up here for his data to where to go, but he's down here. And it knows it's smart enough. What on earth did I do with this material? However, I do think that the tiling here is off. And apparently, oops, I set this up, there we go, earlier so that I can, okay, let's hit P. See how confusingly horrible that is and bright and everything? So we're going to have to fix all that, but I think maybe the tiling might be too big, or too tight, I mean. Because the thing is I don't want the whole thing to pull on a wire pattern, you know, like where you start getting all these like weird ass artifacty shits. The other thing is I gotta mess with the roughness here. I actually want it fairly high, actually. Okay. Height tiling and bump ratio. See, that's where this is getting all. It should be like 0.001 if it's gonna be anything. See how it breaks? It just breaks up these little guys here and there. Like if I go like kind of high, you can see how it breaks up that edge. That was what I originally had. That's too much. That's too much. So maybe 0.005. That feels okay. You just get those little nicks in there. Now the normal map's probably dumpy. I really should go get it. Let me take a look at the parent here. Just double click that. And we'll pull that over here. And what am I using for this normal map? Weave. To be honest, I think it's too... They're too... Well, nah, you know what? It's not going to work because I want to make them thinner. I want to make each weave thinner. But I can't just stretch it in one direction. But however, if somebody did want to give yourself, right now this gives me tiling, and it's just kind of one for one, so it's just a straight multiply. If you want to change the x or y so you can stretch in one direction, you need to append two scalars. Okay, and then that becomes just, I'm not going to name it, but this would be x, this would be y, and then that would be there, and you multiply that by the text coordinate. If you want to shift them, move them, you add, you don't multiply. I know I've gone through that before, but yeah, I need a better weave material here. I don't know, let me take a look here. I don't know what all I've got. Wicker? Maybe the wicker would be handy. I kind of wish that when you did that, it shot you right here. Am I the only one? Let's try the wicker. Nah, not even, right? It's like wood. I mean, tiled down small enough, it might actually be interesting. Okay, now I gotta fix my lighting something fierce. By changing it to lit. What an asshole. Okay, I actually for some reason thought, dang, I really blew out my skylight, didn't I? I forgot, sorry. Alright, so here we go. Am I even seeing that? Yeah, real close. Real close. Other than that, it goes away. So regular tiling, normal tiling, and the all those tilings need to be split. That's the unfortunate fact of it. That my height, normal. Technically, these should match up. But as far as I know, I don't have a height. This is from like a photo from CG Textures, you know? I would have to model it, which isn't hard. It ain't hard at all. In fact, it's fairly quick. But it's not even the right goddamn pattern. I wouldn't do the cross weaves. Everything else seems okay, though. I could get lucky. Let's go to CG Textures and take a look. I know, I mean, I don't know, hopefully you got, if you don't want to watch this, just keep scrubbing forward until you don't see this on the screen anymore. So we need something for the blanket, but the thing is we need a normal map, and you don't get those from here. This is all diffuse, but there's a small chance that we get something that's black and white enough for us to turn into a height map that we can take into substance or something, you know? That might work. See, like that right there seems almost like, I don't like it, but it's useless. Alright, let me plain fabric, wicker, wool, wrinkles, carpets, patterned fabric. Nope. Lace trims. These are handy. Carpet. Carpet is so hard. It's so difficult to do good. When you're right up close on it. See, I could just get the height map off of this for my damn blanket. You know? But why? What's gay about these? And how are they smart? I don't get it. Doesn't take a genius to do this, or a gay person. Anybody could have done this. I don't get why you gotta be a homo genius. I don't think anything's gonna help me here. All right, let's just try Google. Google's dangerous. Oh my god. Blanket normal map. images. That's wicker, isn't it? Fabric normal map, we'll try that. Thing is I don't remember having something like this in Painter. I don't believe I have this substance, that's why I'm here, otherwise I would just be in Painter. I may, but I don't think I do. This right here is fabric for a woman that's built like a brick shit house. I need some kind of fabric pattern, goddammit. I think up at the top's gonna be my better bet. Something like that, maybe. These are very small. This one might be good. That's about what I need, actually. But filter forge, I don't want to take from there. They scare me. I don't want to go use anything from anybody who's going to get mad at me. But of course I could, this is good too. This is Turbo Squid and you can see it's watermarked. So obviously they don't want me to use it. The thing is I kind of do, whatever I do use, I do want to use in my friggin' project. So let's go ahead and get the hell out of here. That's why I said Google's dangerous. I mean, you stay the hell away from this shit. Just don't even look. You can find it, yeah, maybe get inspiration, but don't. I don't know. I try not to use it. It'd be pretty funny if you put this like on your wall with that in there. All right, so I'm gonna go new here. Okay, I'm gonna go to this tiling plane. I'll say it 2048 for now. Okay, now it doesn't look like there's anything here, but that's just because it's like that. Okay, so now, well, I guess I'll pull this up for you guys too, huh? That's only fair. Oh, I didn't want you to do that. I really didn't. Oh, I wish I could pull materials off. Can I? Just want the materials so everybody can see, and don't thank you. Okay, I think that's okay right there, right? You guys can all see what I'm seeing. All right, so fabric. Now I know for a fact I can use all these. Maybe it'll help if I added a layer. Now essentially what I want to do is just look for a good normal and height. So I don't know what the best way to judge that is. Shit, I lost my camera. Because the color is going to get screwy. So what I kind of want to do is just disable the color. And you might ask, well, why don't I just turn this off? I'll show you why. Okay, I'll turn that off, and then I'm going to go pick a new one. Hey, it's back on, right? So let's just disable it, and then it doesn't matter which one I pick. I'm only looking at their normals, their heights. And I mean, I got tiling here, no problem, but I can always tile it back out there. So I think whatever I pick, I'm just going to stick to one. And I mean, I'm liking a few of these already, I'll be honest. And they're going to give me height maps too, so it's fucking beautiful. All right, so let me think. That's okay, but it's very low resi and kind of nappy. It's too big and bulky and weird. That's not bad. Because keep in mind, what are we dealing with here? We are not dealing with cloth, okay? We're dealing with woven plastic, right? These picnic blankets, if you were to run the side of one of these things across your neck, you'd be committing suicide, you know? They're brutal. They cut you. They get all strangly. It's plastic. You know what I'm saying? So that's what it's gonna be. Now I have the material screwed right now. I don't think it looks very plasticky. I gotta get rid of some. I gotta figure out a little bit here. Maybe even try some subsurface or something. I'm not sure, but I do know that I'm not dealing with cloth. I'm dealing with plastic. So that kind of makes this one very appealing. Indeed. So let's see. Base color height. Okay, here's the thing about the height. I don't like that. I wish that the height was more local to just this pattern. These wrinkles here are not going to be driving my force. So, I love it. A little bit of up and down here and there, but maybe that's dirt or something. Small creases. Oh, small creases. All the way up, buddy. Dirt. Pattern hue, pattern color. Contrast pattern type. Okay, no change on the pattern type, pattern size. Okay, pattern just doesn't exist. It's probably leftover stuff. I think that's about as good as I'm going to get for the height. However, I can fiddle with it here. Make sure that we change this to the height channel. And I could pull out some of this black. Also pull out some of this contrasting here. See how that got pulled in a little bit to auto-adjust the histogram? We're going to pull that back out. Try to even it out just a little bit without losing the actual pattern. So this will darken that. So let's pull out some of the black. Now obviously if I go all the way, right, I'm just pulling the black out entirely. And I don't know if I want it. I kind of want to get like a real medium tone to the whole thing. Maybe even, because I could, you know, do something like this, tighten it up, and do something like that. But I'm not sure that's going to make a good height map. And the question is whether or not I even want to use this height map, or if I just want the normal map. It's interesting. I do like it. Question is whether or not I should just make a substance here and now. Because this pattern actually works, to be honest, almost perfectly for the entire size of the blanket. Like what I'm seeing here, my 9 tiles. So I would tile it 3, essentially. If I want to tune it exactly, well, that's the thing. I might as well just keep the tiling for the height and the normal separate. You know, why make this difficult? Let's just export. So let's Control Shift E. Let me pick a good folder. All right, so picnic blanket tiling ought to work. I only need the height and the normal. So I already have normal here, but you know what? I'm kind of thinking, see, I really wish that I could just have a checkbox to turn them off and on instead of having to, didn't mean to do that, instead of having to delete them, you know? Oh well. All right, let's just make a new one. Let's just call this. Rename, picnic. Just call it that. Okay, we'll add a gray. Well, shit, do I want a grayscale? Do I want any other information? Here's the thing, though. I can't pack the normal map. Let's tune the material. Let's get all of it. I don't care about the color. Let's make this plastic. So this, now that I've settled on it, by the way, I can just use this. So that's just height. Now I'm going to create a new one, and I don't know what happened to my thingy. My shelf, I found it. Okay, so what I want to do here is I actually want to do plastic, and this is going to be plastic base. One of my favorite plastics. Now, we don't want our roughness to be this low, because the game's just gonna blast you in the face with this, and that's not cool looking, right? So let's tune that. Okay, it's only from a certain angle. That's fine. I don't want any surface imperfections. I don't want any plastic grain roughness either. Well, maybe I do want a little bit of roughness in there. And maybe I even want to tile this out more. Kind of a magical balance when you go this high of where things start to go crazy. Maybe a macro variation like that would actually help. Because without that, right, see how it kind of pops some of these up? Now they're all even. Now we got a few raised ones. I like it better. Okay, now we don't need metallic, so we might as well throw height there. I don't know if I'm even getting any ambient occlusion. I think what I want to do, real quick, is I want to grab this normal map. So I'm in the right folder. No, I'm not. Okay, so we export that. Normal is going to give me a file called nm underscore swap. Now, I use that name to just signify to myself that it never goes into anything else. It's just a swap out thing. So we'll go ahead and there it is. So I can import that. Okay, so I imported this back in, and now what I can do is I can throw this on here, which will strengthen it for now. And then I can now just bake the textures. So all I gotta do is uncheck normal. I don't need ID. I don't actually need curvature. I don't need jack shit. I just need the ambient occlusion. But it'll be based off the normal map. So we'll throw it at a 2048 for now. Just I can export at any resolution I want, but I'm thinking 2048 because I want it to look better. It's not a very complicated material, to be honest with you, so I think I can go a little high res on it. I'd maybe even go 4096 if I need to, because it would look better. And now now that I have ambient occlusion, and I have height, I should be good to go. So let's create our configuration, and I call this picnic. So we're going to add an R plus G plus B, and this is going to be, we'll call this project, because my texture set, well, I can't show you, but it's named default material. I don't want that to be my name. Okay, so project underscore masks. Okay, and then I need the RGB, and this will be normal. Okay, so we want the direct X normal. We want the roughness, gray channel. We want the height, gray channel. And we want the ambient occlusion, gray channel. Now the ambient occlusion is probably nearly pure white, to be honest with you. It might need some tweaking to get that to actually show through. If that's the case, I can show you what we do. Essentially, we re-export the normal map, bring it in again, which increases its strength again. Eventually, the ambient occlusion will start kicking in something fierce. So it's a delicate balance. But I think this is good right now, right? I just need the masks. So I get my roughness, I get my height, and I get my ambient occlusion, I get my normal. I don't need my metallic channel, so what the piss? Might as well use that. Okay, and then we export, and I think I can hit cancel here and do a save as. Okay, I saved a project called Picnic Blanket. So go to Picnic Blanket tiling here. We're good here. And that should be good. I should get two files. Right there. Oh, yep, no, it's fine. I thought I, for some reason, got a million freaking textures at once. Okay, and then what I need to do is turn masks. I'm glad this happened. Again, I don't know if I showed this before, but every once in a while, given the way that the values of your red, green, and blue end up, you can end up tricking the system into thinking that's a normal map. So you might come in here and you might think, oh, sweet, it's sRGB's already off. It was smart. Don't be fooled. If you see this off and you didn't turn it off, you're in trouble. This is not good. This needs to go to masks, okay? If our sRGB is checked, no matter what you see here, when you come in to do your masks, no matter what you see here, don't do this. Don't touch sRGB. Just change this to the type. So if you change this to mass, always look for what the compression setting is. Because like I said, this can come in, you just saw it, it came in as a normal map. It's not a normal map. So we come in here, and so I have normal there. This is height tiling. Okay, let me bring in the other texture here. Boom. And oops. Actually, I don't need to do that. So we get the tiling here. There should be one right now. That's fine. Roughness. Okay, we'll give ourselves a roughness multiplier here, and we'll default that to 1, so it doesn't have any effect. Ambient occlusion, I'm just going to plug in. And height will actually be that. I do have subsurface. What kind did I pick? I don't actually need two-sided, because I'm not letting the player get off the blanket, so they'll never be able to get around or underneath it. In theory. You know. I had to preface that one real quick. Okay, so this is straight up tiling, this is height tiling, and that's fine that I plug those into the same because they should match up. I might as well plug this into the default here, like so. So it might be a little strong. I did export the normal map at double strength. Now, did I come apply? Okay. Now we can get a feel for it. So height tiling shouldn't not be a lot at all. Should be very low. And that's not bad. Roughness, let's get that back to 1. Subsurface amount, I am piling on right now. 5, nothing goes over 5, doesn't make any difference. Just testing that, I don't know why. But I don't think I really want it all that high, right? I don't know, it doesn't really feel like it's scattering everything. I really would like to scatter this highlight. Maybe something like that. Tone that down a little bit. Again, I got lighting I need to fiddle with as well. So I shouldn't tune the roughness and everything too harshly yet. But that doesn't feel too bad. You get a fairly decent bit of highlighting there. I know I'm not seeing a lot of the screen. But that's, I mean, I'm not seeing it either. So I think I'm hiding it from you guys. Actually, shit, I'll just do this. So, I mean, I think for the most part, you can pretty much detect where the wrinkles are, given the way the shadows and everything are going. The ant's very nice and contrasted here, that is for sure, and I like that. Right? I think everybody likes that. That should show up pretty goddamn easily. I mean, I can still see them. You ain't gonna be playing from here. We may get a little bit of a crazy headache thing going on if you're way out here, but I think when you're down here, it might be okay. Plus, there's going to be other stuff to break it up. Notice how, like, when I'm looking right here, my eyes don't feel like they're... Or, hopefully, you can't notice what my eyes are doing, but maybe you'll notice what yours are doing, and maybe they're not being as assaulted so quickly right here, whereas right here, it's just a little bit of a brutal attack on the eyes. You know, especially when I move it around, right? So, sorry. And I don't really want to go out way out there either. Now, part of it is the fact that I have kind of a high amount of contrast in the material itself, meaning between here and here. But this is the final look that I kind of want to give it. I do need to dirty it up, obviously. So we'll have like some macro dirt or something on this whole thing. Or maybe I'll even paint a mask for that and use some of the blending. Or something, you know, kind of like a, if you think of it like a deposition or a splat map, but instead of for like, you know, flow and all that weird stuff that you get with geology, we just do like ambient dirt or something. I don't know. The fact is that the blanket was rolled out like a while ago. Now, this might be kind of a large blanket as it stands. But what I may not want to do is shrink the blanket. I might actually want to do something like this that feels a little bit more natural about how much of a blanket you would be sitting on. Because here's the thing. I'm not sure I'm going to do that, so let me undo it. If we take a look at back to some of my... I'm already doing this. Scale is kind of going out the window in a lot of ways. When you look at this particular map, sorry, I'm trying, there it is. Okay, so if you look, the rats in here are shorter than the trees that you see in this area over here. Okay, now if you compare those to the size of the cup, and then you compare those to the size of the soccer ball, you can see that the rats are very small. So what I've done is I've made this its own map, and I've scaled everything up and let the characters stay really tiny. Because when a real rat runs around on the actual sandbox that's in the world, he's really huge. He's almost as tall as the soccer ball in reality. You know, so he would be a giant in here. It'd be like 5 times bigger. So I'm doing the same thing on the picnic by scaling all this stuff up. So you're smaller, but the scale of everything is in relation. That way there's just more of a playing field. Now, I know, yeah, all of a sudden, why are my characters now, instead of the size of a rat, they're the size of the ant, you know? And then the ant is now really microscopic in all the scales, but I can't explain that, so kiss my butt. That's all I got for it. But I do know that, you know, a blanket this huge might not be all that cool. With this being as, plus there's a lot of open space, and I really need to start negating a lot of open space. So let's actually see how big that is. Two. Twice as big. Feels fair enough. Doesn't seem... If I was sitting here on my ass, yeah, you know, a picnic basket kind of goes up to like about your waist. So you'd be right here. That might actually be too big. Yeah. Also, they tend not to be perfectly square. No, it's rectangular, right? It's kind of like a towel. Alright, but we'll keep it for now. Let's see if the ants will actually behave. Hang on, no. We should have that. Okay. Let's get rid of him. I've got some stuff in the map. G. Is there anything that's going to cause a problem? Control Shift A. You, buddy. Okay, I definitely don't want like a whole bunch of them. Also, which is really funny, I haven't saved yet. Picnic. All right, you can see we got a few issues here and there, but that's okay. We can fix that later. I'm not worried about that. I can easily flatten it from here, no problem. All right, and the terrain actually kind of... Oh wait. Oh shit. Here's another trick. I forgot to scale that, right? So what I do is I hit Control B, right? Then I come over here and I delete it. Then Control C, V, right click, replace, and I got it back. Right, copy, paste, replace. Okay, so there's one bit of cheese here. I'm not sure that the putting the cheese down logic's gonna work, but I'm assuming it will because I thought that this I did it by visibility. So let's see how they run. See how they run. Oh, buddy. He's good. He's fine. Nobody pay any attention to him. Okay, very, very clearly we should see how they don't align their feet to the terrain, right? They're not aligned to it, they're staying flat. They're big, I'll give them that. They're big ants. They're big damn ants! Alright, so let's... I like them though. I don't think there's going to be too many problems spotting these guys. I mean, they're practically black, but their details are still there for now, anyway. I like him. So I may want to align them to the terrain. I may want to align them to the surface normal that they're on. However, dun dun dun. If I do that, you know, we start kissing goodbye to more of that beautiful FPS, which is already in the shitter. Right? It's not very good right now. But I don't think that has anything to do with the terrain, to be honest. He can't get to his spawn point. There's nobody there. I'm blocked. I'm aborted. What are you blocked by? What are you blocked by, dude? Stop sniffing butt, tailgater. See how he sunk in right there? Yeah, sunk it. But like I said, if I start correcting them for the alignment to the ground, it's gonna get nasty quick. But if I keep only say 30 of them going. Which they're almost there. I mean, the FPS ain't the worst. And again, they're right now they're still in random mode, right? I'm not even in like forced direction mode, you know? I mean, I kinda am, but there's no feed left for them. The game would be over at this point. So, I think they probably have a little bit too complex behavior in a way. For what they're supposed to do. They're supposed to run out and steal the thing. But there's a lot of cases where it doesn't feel good that I wanted to fix. Them getting caught in big groups sucks. You know, it just does. You know, what happens when they steal the food, right? I gotta take care of that. How do they react when one of them goes for the food? You know, that kind of stuff. So, but other than that, they're okay. That still feels like a... This could, you know, even with... You know, like I said, like 30 of them at a time, it could still be, I think, a fairly healthy challenge to have to fight them. Especially if I make it so they don't die in one hit and you have to manage ammo. Now, I'm not going to probably do anything dickish where you can totally run out. You know, obviously there would be a way to gotta have some ammo spawns. Maybe it would be maybe even in here or something where I could put the ammo. I don't know. We'll see. I do think I probably want to redo this thing, though. I don't think it looks that good. It's very generic. At the very least, it needs a paint job. But I'm not sure what I would do. It's high poly already. That's the thing. Not too bad. It's 9400. I think I was fairly reasonable for the era that I made it for. But I could definitely make it higher now. I could go like 20, easy, which would give me the ability to make the top reel. Because what's cool is you can actually see in there. You know, like I really, you know, it's really modeled. So, but you know, from the inside, you're not supposed to see in there. You know. But the reason I did that was because I couldn't put enough geometry in there. I had to cut the back out. So I faked it on the inside, right? So I cut the backs of all these off and then I just put a box in here. That's the smart thing to do, but I may not have to do that anymore. I may be able to make it straight wicker. If I do it smartly, I think I can do it with 20K. Because I didn't knock out half these polygons. I knocked out less than half. All the side segments are still there. It's only the bags. So, I don't know. I mean, it doesn't look horrible. The material's okay, I think. The wood looks fine. Looks like wood to me. It doesn't have much surface normal, but by much, I mean, it doesn't have any. But I don't actually mind that too much, but I mean, you know, it should have some pits and holes. I need a little bit of something in there, right? These guys are still doing their thing. Which is pretty cool. I like that. I can just kind of let them go and they'll just go, you know. But yeah, it would be fairly nice to align to the normal on the ground. And I'm going to do that in the next video, and we can always have the option to turn it off and on. So anyways, this is Hippo signing off. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one.